saying that, you know, that Veda has a surface meaning as well as a deep meaning. Agreed. Therefore, was it intended like this? Not quite. But the point is, even in a word, language like English, take a word like force. How many different meanings it has? Force is used in the physical sense of physics. Force is used in the idea of punching anybody. I force my views on the subject, it is psychological. So even every language has that. But Sanskrit is more systematic, that's all. Therefore, when the Vedic rishis, we have to remember again and again, that Vedas are not human compositions. Veda, as I told you, its a source is the paramevyoman from which it was revealed to a human being. Shruti, we call her. Therefore, by definition, it has several layers. Therefore, only the ordinary people, unless you show something to them. I was telling in the morning, Vishalakshi, all of us have heard the word Gopura. Temple is there, think of Gopura. But did people ever ask the question, Pura means a city. What does Go mean? Does Go mean a cow? City and the cow is it? What is the idea? They have heard Goshti. The point is, we did not bother to ask the questions. Because our environment is not like that. The whole point of Vedic idea is, Veda has each phrase, each pada has several different levels of meaning. Why? Because each word has different meanings, each word. Focus on the word. That is the contribution of birth to birth. Focus on the words. Therefore, first, before studying, list the possible meanings of the words you know. That's why my translation is important, because I focus on a pada. A pada has only 4 or 5 words, that's all, it doesn't have 20 words. Therefore, list down what is it. Then, try to construct a different meanings out of the possibilities. Therefore, I have given in the example, you know, this mantra itself, this Vishuddha. Abhodi Agnim Samhita Janaanam. Abhodi Agnim Samhita Janaanam. That is the example I quote here. It is the first mantra of the fifth mandala. Abhodi has abhodi meanings of kindling the fire as well as Abhigani. Agnim. Jananam, people. Samhita, again fire sticks, are our aspiration. Samhita. Therefore, if you first thing we say, by means of fire sticks, the fire was kindled, ordinary meaning. And you stop, because I have gotten a meaning. People like us ask the question, second meaning. Samhita, by means of the aspiration. Our Agni, our the divine power, was kindled. Abhodi, Abhodi Agnim Samhita Janaanam. Therefore, I have kindled it not only for myself, for all people also. What did I do? I simply took, listed the different meanings of the words and asked this question, what can I make out of that? So the idea of the question is multiple meanings of verses. Why do multiple meanings come? Multiple meanings come because of the multiple meanings of the words, W-O-R-D, words, that is this idea. And so we can divide the meanings into, shall we say, ordinary level. Okay, like I told you, people kindle the agni with the fire sticks, the fire, ordinary thing. Then there is this idea of, shall we say, viewing agni as a deva. And finally, not finally, that's how the adhyatma interpretation. What is adhyatma interpretation? In some sense, we bring in the spirit or the supreme power in every aspect. That is adhyatma. Last time I gave an example, today I will repeat it. For example, take the food you are cooking, okay? So you have a, so let us say, raw rice is there, water is there. So you put the rice seeds into water, nothing happens. You put the rice seeds into sort of a hot water, nothing. So the question is, only when you mix all of them in a particular way, then you get your tasty sambar and that sort of thing. So what is this idea here? The idea is, you are invoking the divine power into transforming the raw vegetables and grains into a tasty food. So what you are doing is invoking or making the divine power enter it. So that, therefore, who gives the taste? In modern science, nobody has given how taste is formed. No biology comes into the picture. Therefore, the particular taste comes in. Therefore, here the examples are only, you know, raw materials or the grains, the vegetables, the spices, and the heating energy is combustion. So we think heat does it. No, heat doesn't do it. Heat uses combustion. As I told you, you put vegetables into the fire, it becomes a smoke. Therefore, that's not the idea. Therefore, all of these, the energy of agni, the energy of the water, apaha, the potential energy in the vegetables, danya, they're all combined together to give you the sambar. Not only that, when a person is psychologically upset, angry and that sort of thing, then the food has a different taste also, even. Whereas when a person is quite happy, he cooks the food. So the Western notion of a recipe is all right, but it is a very narrow idea. If for whole Vedic soap, even that input also comes in. That is, before people even go to the extent of asking, you know, where the food was grown and that sort of thing. You know, we have enemies in places, you know, that is who gave you the food, you know. Before the food came to me from a bad person, it has this quality and that sort of thing. So all of these are there. Dominant at least, you know, the power of Agni, the power of the water, at least minimum, that is the idea, and the power of the grains, a potential. Therefore, the point really is, we get away from the notion, somehow it is cooked. We don't ask more details, how does it happen? We don't ask questions. Ask questions, there is only one answer. It is because of the cosmic powers of apaha, the water, the agni, and the power in the vegetables and the grains, etc., that resulted in the tasty food. That is this idea. So this is the beginning of understanding this whole theory of the different meanings of the words. Therefore, you limit yourself to at some level. Nothing happens. For agni, it is free of fire. That's it. But the question is, here is your example. How did your tasty food come? We never ask the question. Oh, we think of the way the Jataragni, that's also true. But you forget the most important idea, common to all people. Lagni is that power with along with the water, uses all of these things. Therefore, we speak of in one mantra, we speak of these two things. Agnihi Vishwa Shambhuvam, Apaha Vishwa Veshajam. Veshaja, you should not think only as the healing. It heals or should help to appreciate a higher value. So, Agnihi Vishwa Shambhuvam. Sham means peace and happiness. Bhuva to create. Agni create the Shambhu. Apa Vishwa Veshajam. He makes us see, appreciate the divine forces which are helping us. So this is the point of how. So it is not that I created this meaning. Meaning is there all the time, except we become aware of the meaning and somebody points it out to us. So that's how, don't worry about when the word has the sentence has three meanings or five meanings. As a matter of fact, in the recent time, the person who stressed this idea of Madhvacharya, he stressed this idea of the purely physical meaning, you know. And it's, for example, when a thunder comes, it is caused as a physical phenomenon. On the other hand, you know, we speak of the thunder as lightning, as the divine sound and the thunder and divine light. That is this idea. So that's also impossible. Before, the question is, broaden your horizon. Instead of when a different suggestion is made, ask this question. This is the whole beginning of education. Then why not consider it instead of stopping it at first stage itself? That's where education really starts. The alternative is given. Hey, let me consider it. That is this whole idea of the Vedic idea in some sense. So we have some, so then. Replace to criticism, people say, you know, even Sri Aurobindo says, the secret of the Veda was it hidden. See, if you, I want you to read, you know, my book, this Vedic Knowledge in a Modern Context, there I discuss modern's response. People, you know, see, Sri Aurobindo wrote everything in English, okay, everything in English. He quotes the mantras and devani in English script only. And therefore he mentioned the word secrets, not as the title. But his disciple Kapala Shastriya was a Sanskrit, great Sanskrit scholar. He was also a teacher in the school. Therefore, people asked, his fellow pandits asked him, you know, your teacher Sri Aurobindo speaks of secrets. What are those secrets? And you, for example, you say your Sri Aurobindo has given world meanings. Hey, you know, our Sayanacharya gave world meanings based on the Panini's grammar, as your teacher done that. So all of these were solid questions. You simply can't brush aside these questions. So that's how Sri Kapala Shastriya sat down and prepared the Siddhartha. Answering all of these unspoken questions. People, it is casually mentioned the question, hey, you know, you speak of this, so what are the secrets? Therefore, so what did he do? First he wrote what he called the Siddhanjana Bhashya, that is Bhumika. Bhumika means introduction. What are the questions people ask? What are the general ways of answering? That is the introduction. Four chapters, very big, very important.
So our Chinese translation should read more than once, New Light of the Veda. Next is a Sanskrit commentary. So a commentary of any book has to be in the subject matter of that book. So French people say a French book has to be a French commentary, but somehow in English even Sri Aurobindo didn't appreciate. But Veda is in Sanskrit, therefore it commentary has to be in Sanskrit. For example, we all have a difficult problem when the word go comes in. So, how cow is the C-O-W, cow is there, and we call it as a ray of knowledge. Hey, what is the difference? If you know Sanskrit, we call it not the cow, go chid rashmi, rays of consciousness. But the Sanskrit go has also the meaning that which travels everywhere. Go comes the word gacha. The two meanings are close. That which is a ray of consciousness which goes everywhere, and that which is a cow animal goes everywhere. Therefore, the two are not such widely different things as we English wallahs make it tiny. Therefore, he wrote it in Sanskrit, but it's true, most of us don't understand Sanskrit, that's a different question. But let us not make our ignorance as the basis for criticism, that is this idea. Why not ask this question? Hey, let us learn some Sanskrit. So he wrote the commentary on the first 1400 mantras. That is 121 suttas. He didn't stop there. He remembered the question earlier people had posed to him. There, he answered this question about Sayanacharya business. He says, you know, even he himself, whenever possible, they use the Panini's grammar to support the word meaning he has given. What does it say? Panini's grammar can be used to give different meanings for the same word, because it is a very powerful instrument. Therefore he says Sayanacharya was not the only person I have given different meanings. Third question is important. Hey, what is this rahasya? Therefore, the problem with the people, most of you have not done that work, so I don't blame you. All of you know the title of the work, Secret of the Veda, and not only you, most 99.9999% belong to that category. Therefore, later the essays were called as On the Veda. It is, when the book was published after his death, it became known as Secret. See, remember, Sri Aurobindo's disciples think, you know, our master is so perfect. Whatever he wrote is perfect. That is the problem of the Sri Aurobindo didn't feel that way. See, in 1949, they wanted to bring out that 45 itself, 5 years before he passed away. Sri Aurobindo said, nothing doing. This book needs an extensive revision. Since I'm not going to revise it, I don't have time, therefore no publication. Therefore, Kapali started from that point. He says, if his book is not even going to be in print, that whole volume of knowledge is going to go away. Therefore, he started Sanskrit commentary, that is a big background. Coming to this secret business, he was aware of this problem. I tell people, if you want to read the secrets, see, the book Veda has three parts. First part is the essays, about 20 essays, forget it. Take the second part. What it does is, it takes 20 different suttas, gives a detailed commentary on the entire sutta. Not in the sense of our, Sanskrit commentators are better. You take, that's what the teacher, my teacher said that, you know. You take a Upanishad like Mundaka by Shankaracharya or Ramamadhva, they take a word, each word in the meaning, they give a Sanskrit of the corresponding meaning, then at the end they give their commentary. Has your teacher done like this? The answer is no. But even that, but apart from that, he gives a long commentary on 20, so they are the most valuable part of the whole book. So, the word secret bothered Kapali also. You see, the problem with the secret is, the Sanskrit word is rahasya. It doesn't come in the Veda. But the Veda word is what is called the ninya vacham. See, ninya is secret. It does. So, nivachana, people who may reveal it, the secret. Ninya vacham, nivachana. Where does it come? It comes in the fourth mandala, I think 50th sukta or some places. Ninya vacham, see. So then he understood, knowing modern, after all, he wrote the book in 1946-49, that not many people know. So, what he did was, at the end of his book, he listed the secrets one by one by one. So what do you mean by a secret? It could be an incident. Like, putting all the knowledge, covering the knowledge. Vritra, prevents the rivers from flowing. Sarama, who recovers where it is hidden. Like that, it is there. But we are not speaking of one secret. Hey, secrets. For he shows, secrets has different meaning. Each word, many of the key words have their different meaning, different from the ordinary word. That is also a secret. Phrases have a secret. Therefore, what he did was, remember he had commented on 1400 verses. Therefore, he grouped them to two or three together. And for 500 of them, he gave what is the secret there. One line Sanskrit sentence. Okay. Therefore, it is called Rahasya, Veda Rahasyani. So, that is in the sixth volume at the end. I had read it, but you know, I had so many things. But I couldn't pay attention. Now, whole thing has been translated into English. Plus also, in his big commentary itself, there are so many places where he gives detailed explanation. For example, the idea of the Brahmanaspati and Ganapati being same, that is the idea. The idea that the idea of killing a human being, Purushameda, is not, that's another idea. A lot of these things are there. They put all of this in one book called The Secrets of the Veda, English translation. What is this idea? Therefore, for 500 verses, for a groups, 500 groups of them, he gives what is the secret thing. The secret could be, as I told you, meaning of the word, meaning of the phrase, the implication, the broader idea, this. Okay. And I don't think it is easy reading this question, because in some sense, you have to have at least something like the translation I have done, because he says, you know, remember, it's all one sentence. Or he says, in a particular verse, the first 36.5, he will say this word, this is, see the book, his commentary, etc. Therefore, it is not, shall we say, self-contained, no. It goes back. Therefore, people don't read the Sanskrit, obviously. Therefore, they have to read my book, and so it's not easy. But still, it is there. That is the whole argument. When people ask the question, what are the secrets? You should be dumb. There is a book. You should go and read it. And why I am telling that is, you know, you see, in the Shankara Matha, a huge exhibition is there. Some of you, I don't know whether you have gone there or not. It is called Ramarajya Pattabhisheka. Behind Shankara Matha, huge complex has been created. And there, you know, so, for example, day before yesterday, there was a Sudarshana Homa, I went there, and that sort of thing. We have a bookstall also. Lo and behold, a particular gentleman comes there. He is not a Sanskrit wala. He is one of those big construction engineers having his own company. He takes this Secrets of the Veda copy, goes home apparently, reads it here and there, He is impressed. He says, I want to order 100 copies of this book so that I can give this instead of giving the usual Christmas presents and that sort of thing. So this is what I say. Here is a book which I thought is not easy to understand. But, you know, you buy a book. See, you don't have to, shall we say, know all of the content. You pick up some page. Then, so I really combined, first of all, to help people, I put 3 pages, ideas of the Rig Veda. One of the idea is, you know, the gods are always helping you. That idea is there. And therefore, he must have been impressed by something else. Therefore, he ordered 100 copies to be distributed to his friends. So that's how knowledge spreads. You know, the argument you have to understand is, you may take a book. You know, for example, there is this, what is that famous book by this guy, what is his name, this. But he says, you know, I quote that book very often. It deals with oracle or whatever it is. He says, for a person with immense go, the whole world seems to help him. Remember that word?
Kolo.
Yeah, what is that?
Alchemist.
Huh?
Alchemist is the book.
That is the idea. So in that big book, that particular sentence, for a person with a go, the whole world seems to help him in so many different ways. That is this idea. As for it's a big book, one sentence caught the attention. Similarly, some sentence might have caught his attention, and also that's how the greater power works and that sort of thing. Okay? Therefore, the point here is the secrets, you shouldn't think of it as something, you know, giving you $1 million notes and that sort of thing. It clarifies one secret in you. Then, as I told you about the Gopura and that sort of thing, then, hey, you know, I knew already this Gopura was hitting my face, but I didn't understand its meaning. Therefore, hey, similarly, before, so, people were asking in the morning, you know, our mind, we don't understand things because so many different casual things have occupied our minds. Therefore, how do you clear them? Clear them is you put all of those new things there. New things automatically get priority and old things go away because they are not considered. That is the way. Therefore, in reading the books like this, even if you don't understand, even if you understand 10% of it, then you understand something of that. Yes. People have assumed that Rig Veda is ritualistic. So ritualistic means you have the fire, you put in all of these things, that's the way. Therefore I tell people that is not true. It uses the ritual related words. Agni is a ritual related word. Our Krita is a ritual related word used, that's all. Therefore first if you understand that, then it has several different meanings, and I have listed the meanings. You may ask, how did you find the meanings? It is a long method. What is the method? When you say Amartaha occurs 500 times, at least you have to take 100 verses, read them in detail. Hey, what does Amartaha mean? How did we find Ko was one? That is what I did 35 years ago. Therefore, I took Kapali Shastriya's. At that time, I didn't quite believe what he was saying. Therefore, let me see. Therefore, I read all the 120 verses where the word go comes. Then I took a pencil, asked the question, what is the meaning of that word? Therefore, then, you know, there are sometimes two different words come for so the conceptual problem. Then I fix. Only apart from the similes, you know, like just as, you know, a calf comes to a cow and that sort of thing. The only meaning for the word cow or all the vibhaktis, cow, gavaha, he gavam, gavaha, all of that, is for the idea of ray of knowledge. What Kapali would call it as the chitrashmi. rays of consciousness. So this is the method I have to use for all of the works, whenever I had a doubt. Fortunately, I don't have to search, because our Sayanacharya has given a meaning. The question is whether that meaning is sufficient or not. That is the question. Many times it is not sufficient. Not sufficient, still, that is very, very valuable for me, because for all the 40,000 words of Veda, distinct words, leave out the word like iti and that sort of thing. Yes, that's the reason I always tell people it is not a work of Sayanacharya. He distributed the work for 200 different pandits. For each of them, he gave 200 verses or 400 verses. They wrote it, and then he wrote only the bhumika, the introduction for it. That is the reason there is no. People say, what is the difference? In Sayanacharya's commentary, there is no cross-referencing at all. Whereas in Kapali Shastri, whenever he refers to something, hey, look into 10th mandala, 5th sukta, you see it. Same idea is repeated, he would say. Okay. So that's the difference. That's how we know one person did Kapali's work, because of the whereas we know in Sayanacharya's, it is a multiple person work, because there is no cross-referencing. So they use different meanings also. So see, the point is, remember, those who translated the same problems like me, they have to have a meaning. You have to understand that. Therefore, what did they do? They took whatever meaning that came to their head and put it out. Therefore, for common, for the Go, they have at least 125 different meanings in different places. Yes. Different persons spread this idea. Go automatically means walk also. That is a common meaning. I told you in Gopura and others, it has a different idea. Therefore, but then, what Kapali Sayanacharya's disciples did was, whenever they had any doubt about any word, they simply put it as annam, the food. Because annam is everywhere, so that chalta hai, that is this idea. But you have to understand their problem, that they had to write it, that they give it to their teacher. The teacher didn't ask them no qualification, because Sayanacharya had no time for all of that sort of thing. He wanted it, he gave it, that is this idea. So you have to understand the difficulties of the person's house. So simply don't blindly criticize Sayanacharya's commentary, as I was doing myself, but that's very unfair. But it is very useful. Therefore, sometimes for at least, you know, for 1,500 these words, my meaning necessary. Other meaning, for his meanings, or even if it is on the borderline. It's all. That is this question. Okay? But these are difficult, because for each word, you have to take 100 verses at least. Then, hey, find out all the meanings for them. Does this word make sense? And that sort of thing. So then that one you hard work. So that's the reason why this whole idea of multiple meanings of the words are so important, that this idea. So the automatic implication is, once you put in this effort, those meanings come to your head and stay there. That is this question. So, in some sense, they displace all the other things also there, you see, that is this idea. The point really is, there is a deeper insight. That's all. Minimum thing is, don't keep only about the minimal idea of surface meaning. There is a deeper meaning which can be used for cross-referencing, that is this idea. Therefore, when we speak of the secret, you see, a secret, of course, is unique, but there are several related events. For example, we speak of the hills being sort of smashed by cows. No, that's not the idea. Hill is ignorance, kavaha is knowledge. Therefore, so the such usages are there in other places also in the Veda. Therefore, that's the reason we should have this comparative idea. For Veda does not depend upon Puranas or any other things. Veda reveals its own secret. That is our Aurobindo's fundamental principle.